let's study about a new chapter called electricity. So you know what is electricity? Everybody knows, everybody is aware of electricity, right? In our day-to-day activities, we cannot survive without electricity. What are the things that use electricity around us? Mobile phones for charging purpose, television in the kitchen, mixer grinder, oven, computers. If there is no electricity, then these would not run at all. Moreover, we think of batteries, we think of electricity, right? There is battery backup everywhere, right? Electricity is also used for running the geysers at home, and all other appliances in our day-to-day life run with the help of electricity only. If the geysers do not run, if the heaters do not run, then we do not get hot water for the bathing purpose. Then if the home appliances do not run, if mobile phones don't run, how will we be able to communicate with each other? In olden days, when there was no electricity, what does people used to do? People used to light oil lamps, and then people used to burn coal for the purpose of electric energy for cooking, or they used to light lamp for the purpose of lighting during the after the sunset city. Electricity is very comfortable, right? What are the advantages of electricity? It is very flexible to use. You have to just switch on and switch off the fan or any light, right? So it is very flexible to use, and then electricity is very efficient. Whatever electricity is there, we will completely use it efficiently, 100%, right? So there are many advantages of using electricity. Flexible, and it is comfortable. Transportation of electricity is very easy, right? Just you have to connect two wires to poles, and then electricity is transported. Whereas transportation of coal, transportation of oil was very difficult thing. So such is the importance of electricity in day-to-day lives. So whenever we think of electricity, we should think of switching on, just switching on and off, and there are sockets also. So all this electricity makes something called, has something called charge. This charge is made up of protons, electrons and neutrons. So protons are positively charged particles, electrons are negatively charged particles. Neutrons do not have any charge. So in this chapter we will be dealing only about protons and electrons. So whenever water is flowing in a mountain or through a river to a mountain, there will be charge in this flowing water. That is only what produces electricity, and electricity is measured by SI unit called ampere, and electricity is denoted by capital I. So this flow of electric charge produces electric current, right? And electric circuit, you think of electric circuit, right? Whenever the circuit completes, then only electricity flows, and the electricity is passed, and then lights are switched on, fans are switched on. So in this chapter, we will be studying in detail about electricity, Ohm's law, potential energy, different forms of energy, what is electric potential and other things.